our spiritual home of it, ladies and gentlemen. They clean this place up just this week for you guys. No, it's really nice. This is actually our 5,000th show. So we've got a very special program for you tonight. We are doing a series of shows where we change up the set list pretty radically. And tonight we are going to be spotlighting the Apollo 18. That's okay, folks. We've got two more songs for you, and then we've got to fly back to London. So how's everybody doing? I said, how's everybody doing? We're doing good, too. How are you doing, John?
Right.
Somehow I don't believe you at all.
Putting up a wall of question marks. No one knows how I'm doing. Not even I know how I'm doing.
In that case, I'm going to take my guitar off.
I just got to warn myself that there will be strobe lights during the show. And if I passed out in the last song, it's just a warning to me.
Understood. Yeah, there are strobe lights.
I just learned that.
There's also going to be rock music.
No! That's crazy!
And there's going to be some vulgarity. Who knows when we'll go off on some weird MAGA rant unexpected.
But then they'll be making up.
But the thing that is good about QAnon we were just discussing whether QAnon actually still is. Or if somebody was like, you know, that's all fake, right? But it's hard to know. It's hard to know.
QAnon is just like, nah, I'm just kidding.
Don't tell Rosenbaum. But hey, people, we got so many things to do here. This is another song of Apollo 18. It features the guitar strumming of Mr. Dan Miller.
Yeah.
emotionally. Tell us how they feel.
After being emotionally unavailable for so many years. When can we talk about it?
All right, John. So here's another song, informational song, kind of. Probably some untrue facts.
I think this is all true, isn't it?
I don't know. We haven't
been. I feel like we would have gotten like the angry email from.
Oh, I think we
would. Someday we'll start answering those emails.
Anyway, this song is about mammals. It's called. Semicircular thing who's you know, we're going line.
Well, if we were better at lip reading, this show would be no problem.
Because you guys know the words. We don't know the words. You guys. You know the
words. Alright. Here's a song that my mom hates.
across the street, but we pulled him back in.
Words fail. Built in some moments, the ground opens wide. My beams down from heaven. She stands before my eyes.
Express it in words, he would do this.
Remember that guy?
Yeah. I think he's like a big deal now. I think he like engineered like you know, some grunge record like 3 months later, and then was like a multi-million-dollar producer in Los Angeles. That's like the sort of the story of our career. Like they'd be like, remember that guy in the back? Yeah. It's like, oh, yeah, he's Jesus Christ now.
We're still playing our songs up here.
I hope we weren't mean to him. So here's a song that for decades, John and I were like, you know, the interesting thing about that song is he cannot play it live. But Mr. Danny Wyckoff, he broke the spell and challenged us to learn it. So here it is, yeah. Entertaining pleasure. This song is called Fingertips. So, folks, we are doing two sets tonight, so there will be a chance to get more beer in between. So we're going to take a momentary break from our Apollo 18 selections to play some other songs. My amp is making a very, very quiet screaming sound. I'm going to turn that off right now. So, John, just to grab the wheel here first.
Yes, yes. This is from our Grammy-losing still the newest thing that we've done.
Still the newest losing thing we've done.
from 3 years ago.
Yes. Yeah!
I was reminded a couple of weeks ago by a friend of mine that we always lose our Grammys to dead people. So, which is a way of reminding you that it could be worse. Because, like, you know, we're better. Yeah. Oh, wow.
Imagine.
Got a whole new way of thinking about it.
Talk about it.
Yeah. Right. It's like, I want a Grammy and I'm dead. It's win-win.
We always, for decades, we thought Grammys were dumb. And then we won one and we stopped saying we were dumb.
It's like the Godfather, you know.
They keep pulling us.
Yeah. It's like, how about, what do you think? Maybe you win again? Nope. But anyway,
you put your right foot in, you pull your right foot out, they keep dragging you back in, you do the hokey pokey, and you win the Grammy. That's what it's all about.
I don't know what show I'm in anymore.
Hokey pokey, Flansburg. Keep your eye on the prize. Hokey pokey.
So, like a couple of years ago when this book album came out and we started talking about it in this show, I was trying to make a joke out of how long we've been talking between songs right now. We made 15,000 copies, and so we used to try to remind people to like buy them at the t-shirt stand. But I think now we're just down to like a few hundred left. So if there's anybody in the audience who's like totally into arbitrage on eBay, this is your opportunity. You can sit on these things for like a year, and then it'll be like $400. The rarest They Might Be Giants thing. Book out of print for 1 year. So, John, what's the key of this song? That's the key of A, right?
Yep.
By the time you read. Thank you.
Yeah.
The show is going by too fast, John.
I'm trying. We need to do more endless talking. Thank you. People come for the talking.
I see people in the audience.
Yes.
Stretch it out.
Stretch it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, remember that John Stewart show we did where the woman who was conducting, it was a live broadcast on New Year's Eve.
Yeah.
And we were doing, and she was like, why can't I count in the songs? It was really fascinating. It's like, because we do songs at different tempos. They're not just all like one, two, one, go! Yeah. And she knew what she did. So, what's next?
Well, we got another song from Paul IT.
All right.
This was the featured single where we got to drive vintage cars around in these holes.
Oh, yeah.
Which was kind of nuts. The people who owned the cars were watching us.
Right. I just think an insurance payoff.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, and we have these professional skate people.
Yeah.
And they totally, what's the term in sports where you clutch? What is it called when you can't choke? They totally choked. I actually went to like one of the auditions and they were like awesome. But when I guess the real thing is we put helmets on them where they probably couldn't see. That might have fucked them up.
And they were right.
Yeah.
Didn't protect them, really.
Right. That would have been a good outtake.
Anyway, so this was that song.
That they might be giants, faces of death, Apollo 18.
Yeah.
some secret song stuff into the show from Apollo 18 coming up, but now we're just going like,
you know, free range.
So this next song is from the John Henry album. It's in Ohio, a very particular state that I lived in for a few years, and it's called Out of Jail.
Thank you.
Venus. I'm a man, they go for the planet, to the planet. Venus. Thank you.
That's right.
Mr. Danny Wyckoff has broken his ankle, ladies and gentlemen. He had his still rocking to him. He's broken his foot.
Let's do it.
His whole body's ruined. He's broken my foot.
He broke my foot.
And,
oh, I'm sorry.
Break
down the floor! It sounded bad, whatever it was.
Well, he's here, ladies and gentlemen. Mr. Taylor.
Thank you.
cover.
Song's called Bill's Bill.
I'm
does this mean?
Stage.
I know. We'll, You know what you did.
Yeah. I'll be like Dickie Betts and just like climb onto a bus. rivers.